everyone, and welcome to my kitchen. Woohoo! Today I'm here to do a grocery haul under $40. As many of you know, I love my bullet journaling, and in my bullet journal videos, I tend to make a lot of spending trackers and meal planners. And I think because of that, I get a lot of questions about how to stay on budget at the grocery store and also how to buy for one person. So I figured the best way to tackle both of those questions is just to show you an example of a week of groceries. I am gonna start hauling these groceries to the right of me, and along the way, I will share some tips that will hopefully help you out. If not, that's unfortunate, but this is gonna be a whole video on food. So what's not to love about food, right? Silly question, nothing is to not love about. What? What was the question? What's not to love about food? Nothing. Nothing was the correct answer. I really need to go back to school. The first item in my haul is a potato. And if I sound excited, that's because I am. Because potatoes are awesome. You can bake them, you can fry them, although I don't fry them because then my house or my apartment would be set on fire. You can cut it up differently and get different crispy levels depending on how you cut potatoes, as you can tell. Potatoes are my jam. I think it's really important that when you're buying groceries on a budget that you make sure that a majority of the items on your grocery list can be used in many different ways. So for that reason, I do tend to buy a lot of produce, which is great because it forces me to cook. Every week, I usually also pick up a pepper. I usually only get one because you can cut it into, you know, 3 or 4 slices, use a slice per dish, and that's usually enough to get me through the week. Mushrooms have become a very new favorite of mine. These are white stuffer mushrooms. I accidentally got the white stuffer version. I usually get just the regular white mushrooms. I don't really know what the difference is between a stuffer and a regular mushroom, except that these look ginormous. I've been loving using mushrooms in a pasta dish that I think I Instagrammed a month or two ago. It is so addicting, and many black bean burger recipes also call for the use of mushrooms, which is not something I make often, but I do want to nail down that recipe. Just in case you were wondering, I am a vegetarian, so you won't see any meat or fish in this video. One of my go-to snacks are apples. This week I picked up Granny Smith apples because they were on sale, which is another tip that if you are buying things at the grocery store and want to stay on a budget, especially in the produce section, buy the things that are on sale. So even though I go to the grocery store with a list, I try and be very flexible with it just because you never know what the prices of certain vegetables or fruits are going to be. Sometimes it's just really unreasonable. Like, I love grapes, and if I could buy it every week, I would. But grapes get so expensive here in Ontario. Sometimes it doesn't click in my head that if it says grapes are $3.88, it's $3.88 per pound. So it can quickly add up. And that's something you have to be aware with produce in general, is that things are usually priced by weight. The next item is bananas. I'm going bananas for bananas, and that was a horrible pun, but I usually do buy bananas every single week because the prices of bananas tend to be pretty reasonable. I love using bananas for banana pancakes. I showed the recipe that I use in my what I eat in a day video. It also makes a really good on-the-go snack. It's yellow. There's so many positive things going on for bananas. This week I also picked up some organic green beans. I love pairing green beans with potatoes, or even sometimes incorporating them into stir fries. If you put them in a pan with some onions and then afterwards drizzle a bit of olive oil on them, oh my goodness, it is so good. I also like to get strawberries only when they're on sale. This is one of those fruits that if they're not on sale, it can get really pricey really quickly. These ones are organic, which is even better. I always like to make sure that when I buy fruit, especially fruit that needs to be washed, that immediately after grocery shopping, I wash it and cut it and put them in glass bowls so that they're ready in my fridge whenever I feel like I want a snack or a topping for my pancakes. That's the best way I feel like I ensure that I don't waste fruit, because if I let it go unwashed in my fridge, I just find that I'm not as quick to eat it. Another staple that I get every single week is a box, yes, this is a box of baby spinach. Usually I do get the organic version, but they didn't have any of that available, so I just got the regular box of spinach, baby spinach. And baby spinach is just a really great green to have on hand because you can toss it into almost everything. I also like to use spinach to make green smoothies in the morning. So Yeah, go spinach. A new favorite, but definitely a staple every week, is Silk's coconut milk for coffee. A few months ago, I made the switch from milk to like milk alternative products like soy milk or coconut milk. And I really like the fact that Silk has recently come out with these smaller sizes of their milk alternatives that are specifically for coffee, because that's pretty much all I ever used milk for in the first place. I don't even get through this whole thing within the 7 to 10 days I think that this is good for after you open it. So I'm really glad that I started getting these, because I'm not wasting as much milk as I used to, whether it's dairy or non-dairy. I just have no use for a huge carton. I feel like this video has been made up of a little bit too many healthy things, so let's just bring ourselves to Junkland with the Dr. Edgar Ristorante vegetable pizza. I would be lying to you if I said that I didn't always have like at least one of these on hand. I am a student, and there are nights where I just have no time to do any sort of cooking or to even think about cooking, because I'm so focused on work for school or work for YouTube. So sometimes a pizza gets popped in the oven. I do, however, try not to make this a habit in my diet, because even though I'm having it at home, it's still fast food. But you know what? Sometimes desperate times call for desperate measures. And this one's actually really good, if I'm gonna be honest. Another frequent staple is this Gogo Quinoa Fusilli Rice and Quinoa Pasta. This is the only pasta that I really eat now. One bag gives me usually two meals. You can definitely find cheaper regular pasta in the supermarket, so you could save a few dollars there. But because I love this so much, I'm willing to pay, you know, the extra few dollars to get a rice and quinoa version. This is one of those items though that if I do see it on sale, I buy it in bulk so that I can save some money down the road. I actually have a lot of things in my pantry that I go to Costco for, and I buy it in bulk, and you save a lot of money that way. My quinoa I buy at Costco, Mary's crackers I buy at Costco. There's a lot of things I get. If you wanna see me do a whole video on what I keep in my pantry, then let me know in the comment section down below. I believe the last items I have here are these Laura bars. I've got two of them, and I got it in the peanut butter chocolate chip flavor. I recently discovered these bars, recently as in, you know, about a month ago. They're a really new obsession, but I really like having these on hand, because if I ever have to go to a meeting or class and I know I haven't really eaten anything recently, then at least I know I won't, you know, starve with one of these in my bag. This will kind of tide me over until I can have a proper meal. The original total for everything I showed here today was $40.48. However, I did get a student discount, which brings me to my final, I guess my final-ish tip, which is to buy your groceries on student discount days. If there's a grocery store near or on your campus, chances are there probably are days where they offer students discounts. So don't be afraid to ask your cashier if they offer it, and if they do, when you can get those savings. This week I saved $4.06 because of my student discount, and that brought the grand total to $36.42. I don't know about you, but I think $4 is a pretty great discount. Sometimes it's like $5, just depends on what I'm buying each week. And you know, if you multiply that by however many weeks you're in school, it can mean a significant amount of money that gets to stay in your wallet, which is never a bad thing. That is all I have for today's grocery haul video. I hope you got something from this video. If nothing else, you got to see what I sort of what I buy each week, because like I mentioned before, it does change from week to week. If you did enjoy today's video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. I'd love to hear some of your tips that you have for me and for others who are watching this video on how they can save money when grocery shopping, and or how to buy for a single person, like how to know if you're buying too much or too little, that sort of thing. Like any tips that you have for grocery shoppers, leave them down below. I think it'd be great to hear what you guys have to say. I know for me personally, an area where I can maybe improve is to start looking for, you know, farmers markets where I can maybe pick up some of this produce, because usually you can get even better deals when you're buying directly from farmers. I will see you all very soon with a new video, and until then, bye everyone.